Tetrodontidae Arothron Meleagris, or for short, puffer fish.
It's an inflatable puffer fish. This model is my response to Jonah Kashima's tutorial for Li Jiaohui's puffer fish. In particular, it's a response to all the comments asking for a 3D puffer fish. Here it is! And with Christmas coming up, I designed this simple origami hook that can turn the puffer fish into an ornament. And for the hook, I have a separate tutorial here. Ready, set, here goes. Alright, so for this model, I'm going to use a 10-inch square of kami, but you could use a sheet of printer paper cut square. Begin white side up and fold diagonally in half. As always, try to make really precise folds and crease sharply. We're making a water bomb base, but I want to make it extra exact, so we're going to make it slightly different. Unfold and rotate and fold in half in this direction. And unfold, turn over, and fold in half. Make it extremely exact. And unfold and fold in half in this direction. Now unfold, turn over, and push the middle point in, and bring these two points down to here, and flatten. And water bomb base complete. Now fold this flap to this point. And repeat. Unfold and fold the flap to this point. And fold this flap to the crease. Unfold, and now we're going to open here and push the flap in. And as you do that, you can pinch here to make it easier. Push it in and flatten. So there's the reverse fold. Again, it was like this, and we just pushed it in like that. Now fold this flap up like this so that these two points touch these two points. And fold this flap over the edge. And repeat all of that on this side. So unfold and fold this crease to this middle. You can see that you're perfect by looking here. Fold up like this. Unfold, open, and reverse. Push it in. Fold up like this. And fold this flap over and back. Rotate. And fold these two flaps together. We're folding on this point, and we're folding this edge to here. And now fold these flaps down. We're folding on this point, and we want the fold to be parallel with this edge. Rotate and fold these two flaps between this point and this point. And slip them underneath this flap. Like that. Unfold this flap, and the tail is complete. Okay. Now turn over, and it's time to work on the face and the fins. So, fold this flap to the middle. Repeat. Unfold these flaps and fold them to the top. Now fold this flap down so that this crease aligns with this edge. And repeat. Okay, here's a cool move. What we're going to do is open this pocket, put your finger all the way inside, and pretend like we're gonna squash it, but don't squash it. Instead, just take this interior flap and turn the page over like this and flatten it like it was, like this. And repeat on this side. So open it like you're gonna squash it, but then just take this flap and turn the page and bring it back like it was. Okay. Now fold this flap like this and fold this flap so that this edge aligns with this edge. Rotate, open here, and pull out this flap. And flatten. Fold this flap over. And insert this flap into this pocket. Like that. And now fold this flap down, just the single flap. This is going to be the mouth, and these are the two eyes. Fold this flap over on the center line. Make sure it aligns perfectly with the center. That's important. And now open the pocket and squash. And fold the flap down, unfold, and fold to the crease. And fold it down. Now fold this flap to this point. And repeat. Okay, now open this pocket and we're gonna squash it. If you need to, then stick a pencil inside. But I'm using 10-inch paper, so it's pretty easy. Just like that. And repeat. Okay, those look pretty gnarly, those eyes. To make the eyes, open it and just kind of make it round like an eye. But I'm not gonna do that yet. Oh, if you wanna make small eyes, you could just fold it like that. Okay, but I think it's better to have large eyes, but I don't wanna do that yet because it's three-dimensional and I don't wanna flatten the model and mess it up. Okay. Now let's work on the mouth. So, open here and flatten like this. And now fold this flap over so that it aligns like that. And open here and squash. We're squashing so that this crease lands on that edge. And now bring it over like this. And we're going to make one fold here so that it's centered. I'm going to open that up so you see it. So it's just like that. And now make a little reverse fold. Like that. And there's the mouth. And if you want, you can open it so it's like shouting. That's what they look like. I don't know. Okay. But I'm going to leave it like that for now because I want to work on the fins. So, turn over. Here we have the tail. Bring that back up like it was. Okay, fold this flap over the edge. And unfold and turn the page and refold this flap. Okay. Now we're going to make the fin. Decide how you want the fin to look. I'm going to just kind of roughly say here and here. It doesn't really matter. You decide what line you want. But in any case, you want to make that as a mountain fold. So pinch along that line. And now pinch it and fold it flat. And when you fold it flat, you're going to have to push this paper in to make the pleat. And that's to taste, like that. Now we're going to do it on this side, but it's going to be a little bit more challenging because it's more layers. So make the fold, pinch it, and flatten. So there it is. And on this puffer fish, I put a bunch of extra pleats there. I also pleated the tail, but I'm not going to do that. I'm going to just keep it simple. So just fold this behind like that and repeat. So fold these flaps over. Oh wait, bring this flap like that and fold over. So we have the guideline and unfold and now fold it over and fold it like this. And make your swivel folds. Okay. And lastly, make the eyes. And the mouth. Oh, by the way, the eyes can close like that. They can blink or wink. Okay, time to blow it up. When you do that, make sure to hold the fins down like this. Okay, here it goes. Got it. Almost hyperventilated there. All right, so there's the completed puffer fish. And this model can also be a finger puppet. Like that. Now to unpuff it, well, first, a little warning. If you unpuff it and repuff it, it's going to look a little bit messier perhaps, or maybe you like it more like that. Anyway, I'm going to show you how to do it. So what you do is you unpuff it just by bringing it back like this. And now you're going to bring these together like this and fold between this point and this point just loosely like that. Okay, so it's like this, and now repeat on this side. So fold this flap like this, and now open here, and holding right here, we're going to pull this flap out as you squash, like that. And now just fold this flap behind. And this flap can be used as a stand, like that. Or if you want, you can try to tuck it underneath here, like that, so it stays. Either way. So when you want to puff it up again, push this back in, get it into the shape like this, and blow into it. And there it is. And lastly, to turn it into an ornament, first fold this ornament hook, which I taught here, and now slide it into any of these pockets, really. Slide it in until that flap goes in there, and then it locks. And it's an ornament, and it can hang from your rearview mirror. Or from your finger, and it can swing around.
Or it can hang from a vest.
And it can hang from a Christmas tree. And I recently performed at a Christmas party and I put these on the tree. And there it is.
Hope you all enjoyed folding this puffer fish, and now time to swim away. Merry Christmas!